We have arrived in Columbus, Ohio for arguably the biggest gathering of hypercars outside of Monterey Car Week or just a Sunday in Monaco, the Triple F Collection, the Event 2. It's a charity car show benefiting Make-A-Wish Foundation. I am out here with the 312 Supercars team.
What's up, guys?
Mike with the Red 2 Supercars and the true boss, Dr. K. Mikey took the M5 CS out. Dr. K and I went the comfortable route and we drove out in the Rolls-Royce Ghost. But we have the M5 CS on display. It will be in the supercar area. The hypercar area is going to be epic, utterly insane. So we'll be vlogging it, seeing what it's like. We also have some friends out here too. Shmi 150 will be here, as well as I think Stradman's here and some other guys. Should be an awesome time. We get to park next to the i8. This is such an honor. The i8 is such a fantastic piece of engineering. I love that car. The doors go up. It's got a carbon tub.
In case you didn't know, I owned an i8 for 2 years. That's why I like it so much.
Aura Blue. Oh, I'm jealous. I wanted an Aura Blue R8 so much, but I couldn't find one, so I have a basic white one again. Kind of like how Mikey's a basic white boy who drinks Starbucks like water. We've got our fancy wristbands, official wristbands.
M5CS parked, Mikey has his Starbucks, so we're set there. This thing is awesome, so we're grouping cars, BMWs, there's some Audis over there, Ferraris, Lambos are somewhere over there, so there's some organization.
I thought about bringing the R8 out, but decided against it for this trip here. I follow this guy on Instagram. He's got some awesome signature forged wheels on his R8 V10 Plus and an F12. It's a sign. I really want to buy one of these. Oh, yes.
Do I do it?
Yeah.
The problem is, it's like, when am I ever going to drive the R8 or the Shelby if I have that in the garage?
Drive that every day and then you have the other cars you just appreciate. Because it's the one that you're going to get.
Eddie, you can only drive one.
Dr. K with some wisdom.
You only drive one at a time, but you definitely need a Ferrari in your state. So it's time to buck up.
Oh my God, there's a Devo. Say hello to the hypercar area for the Event 2. Front and center, F50, F40, Huayra BC Roadster, the Chiron Super Sport top speed, and a Devo. Holy crap. First time ever seeing one of these in person. I did get to see a Devo at Car Week when it first came out. That's matte blue carbon fiber. This is all gloss black carbon fiber with the orange accents. Holy crap. You just hear the sounds of supercars parking. There's definitely an Aventador out there because the Aventador exhaust is unmistakable. But then look at these. Works of art, works of engineering. The Bugatti Devo. Just look at the rear end. Look at the way the taillights are set up. The massive wing. And then we have the extended top speed car. That's insane. Huayra BC, super unique spec. F40?
Right here.
Oh, yeah. F50. Oh, this SVJ, I believe, has a Gentani exhaust, so it sounds insane. Oh, look. Another F40 over here. This is one of the most badass camera car setups I have ever seen. Golden Peaks Productions. That, the camera setup maybe cost more than the car. Holy crap. That's legit. And it's not like they have it on a 335i. That's an M3. That's an E90 M3. All right, LaFerrari 300S. Oh my God, this is just, oh, there's an Elva back there too. 992 Turbo S, 4GT. A Koenigsegg Regera. Okay, another Chiron, the Triple F car. And then, oh wow, first time seeing the Triple F Huayra BC Roadster in person. This is also a unbelievable spec. Look at that. Oh my God. I love the Huayra BC. It's one of my dream cars. I am fortunate to have gotten a ride in a Huayra BC coupe and a Huayra back to back, and it was a mind-blowing experience. They are absolutely just works of art. Everything is carbon fiber, billet aluminum, or like leather. That's it. Reversing up a hill in any single clutch Lamborghini is always stressful. Better in an SVJ than like an E-Gear Mercy, but. Initial reaction from Mike.
Utter insanity. This ruined car is number one. But also number two, I think I'd still have the 300 SM. I didn't ever just talk to
him. Yeah, it's beautiful.
I mean, look at just how simple this is. Like, imagine in the 1950s, 1954 to 1957, this was produced. Imagine pulling up anywhere in a 300 SL.
Well, apparently your dad did, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah. You had a 300 SL, right? Like one of these.
Well, no, it was a
V6 one that was falling apart.
SL300, a little bit different.
If you're a little dyslexic, it's the same thing. This is absolutely beautiful. The original Gullwig. Now we have the SLS.
Of course,
but look at the interior, too. The plaid seats, the full luggage set. Yeah, this is a work of art. And this one is just like absolutely perfect. You gotta appreciate something like this. I personally don't love old cars as much as modern cars.
If you ask me what to own, I will disagree with Mikey. I'll take one of the more modern cars. I love the Pagani Huayra BC. But you have to respect what that car represents. It's where the automotive industry came from. Again, work of art, and just something like that is truly, truly special.
And we have the McLaren section of the Triple F collection, or part of it, I guess, because that's their full carbon 765. Here's a 675 LT.
Fun fact, the first time I ever got to ride in a 675 LT was actually in Columbus, but I was a lot fatter, and I tried to sit in the buckets, and my butt didn't touch the actual seat. I just kind of got wedged in the bolsters. So that's like my lasting memory of the 675 LT.
It did incentivize me to lose weight a little bit, because I was like, man, I don't even fit in a McLaren. A Triple F P1. Gorgeous spec. It's amazing that this is like over a decade old now, I think, or almost, getting closer. That's when the hybrid hypercar Holy Trinity came out, and personally, as a McLaren fanboy, the P1 is going to always be my favorite. And then we have the Speedtail, which is finished in insane carbon weave. Just trying to show this and on the camera is hard. The Speedtail has a little flexible wing in the back here, extended in length. Oh my god. And then the Senna. Casually, another Senna here. So the front end of the P1 and the Speedtail are pretty much parked right in line with each other. Now look how much longer the Speedtail is. The P1 ends and it just extends out back there. The Speedtail truly is just like a alien spaceship. The styling, the technology, the roof scoop, and it's a three-seater. The aero wheels too. And then we have an Elva. I've actually already gotten to see two in person up at Kearns Motor Cars. They had a Colorstream one and a Napier green one. Did a couple videos with it. This is probably the least practical car you can buy here. Like, because again, there's no roof or windshield, so you better wear a helmet. Because if you get hit in the face by a bug while driving this thing, it'll probably hurt. Because it's the same powertrain as the Senna, but weighs a lot less. Beautiful spec on this one. And it's really cool how the exterior and interior flow together. So the entire dash is painted, the center console here coming up behind the seats. It blends the exterior and interior of the car. McLaren paints are also so nice. This paint is beautiful. And then the rear end of the Elva, if you take a look, it's got like that mesh metal hexagonal cutout finish. If we come over here and check out the newest of the McLarens, the Artura, the hybrid V6 one, you'll see the rear design element is very similar. Full carbon 765 LT Spider with these kind of blue glauco or light blue, aqua blue accents on it. Full carbon fiber body too. And you'll see the difference in carbon fiber weave of this one compared to the Speedtail. This is more conventional carbon fiber weave. Holy crap. More YouTuber entrances. Street Speed 717 with his SVJ. I haven't seen Mike in a long time. That's quite a cool livery on the car. And obviously it sounds epic.
The Mercy SV is the poster car. It's the top tier iteration of the Murcielago, which is like my poster car. It's the top V12 Lambo when I was a kid growing up. And it's extra special and rare because they never finished the entire production run. So seeing one of these, it's one of the rarest of the V12 Lambos, the modern era. Like, that makes an Aventador look kind of normal because it's a Mercy SV.
And this one is a gorgeous dark blue paint with the silver SV lettering. At night, it almost looked like it was black until you got closer. You see it's a dark blue, silver lettering, the big SV wing. Yeah, and that plate is epic, dropout, and a V12. It doesn't get really much better than this. And the interior, a little dated compared to the Aventador, but still just so epic. The bucket seats, Lamborghini triangular pattern too, going across the floor too, oh my god. Look at that on the Diablo, they have the firing order of the cylinders listed out there. That's something Lamborghini keeps doing, it's a really cool touch. another purple Lamborghini. And now we reach the Chicago portion of the show, starting with some of the Hamilton Collection cars, the Rizvani Tank with the best license plate I've seen in a while. This and Dropout are two good plates. 6x6, P1. Steve's brand new LaFerrari, well not brand new, new to him, LaFerrari. 918, I think that's a Y-stock car, the Pagani Huayra, 765 LT, the Senna is Countach, the Chiron, which we took a ride for to go to Costco. So I can say I've been to Costco and a Chiron, thanks to Steve. And then another collector from Chicago, Acid Green 918. This car is Salamandrin's old 918 Spider. I was on a bus one year heading to Pebble Beach, and the owner of that car was sitting next to me on the bus or something like that, and we were talking about, I don't know, cars, YouTubers, and he was like, do you know Salamandrin? I'm like, yeah, I know Alejandro. I think I'd just gotten lunch with him the day before. And he was like, I bought his 918. I was like, oh, whoa. So yeah, that one is internet famous, an amazing spec on that 918. Same guy also owns this Pagani Huayra Roadster in full exposed blue carbon fiber, the nicely matching contrasted interior. And you see what I say about Paganis? Everything is carbon fiber, aluminum, or leather. Everything. Absolutely beautiful. Look at the rear aero flaps up on the Huayra Roadster. The Huayra Roadster is so pretty, and the top-down experience is probably unbelievable, but I just am so sad it doesn't have gullwing doors anywhere, which physically wouldn't really be possible, but compromises have to be made, right? Look at the titanium, too, on the exhaust. Wow. And then we have Ford GT, McLaren P1, a Speciale, and another F40. So there's three F40s here. And there's another Chiron over here, too. When I say there's just hypercars strewn all over the place, you could obviously see. This is, I think, the fourth Bugatti here? Fifth! Five Bugatti Chirons, iteration of the Chirons. I'll count the Devo as a Chiron too. Looks like two Huracan STOs and a nice lineup of four GTs. Old with a new one in the middle. Heritage 4 GT. This guy still has a Japanese plate on his V-Spec R34. That's a flex.
How you doing, Mike?
Doing alright. I mean, worse than I'm walking with you here, but
this is constant emotional abuse that I get. This is an abusive relationship.
No, I wouldn't say that too loud. Unless you want some rumors on Life Apollo's or whatever.
Mikey found a Mercedes and now he's excited. This one looks like a Skittles though, whereas his looks like a chalkboard.
Hey, the graphite gray is pretty sick.
It looks like a chalkboard. Kidding. They all look amazing, but I like bright color cars. GT Black Series. Was the fastest car around the ring. I think it still is. Is this still the fastest car?
M4 CSL.
M4 CSL? No, wait, no way.
I swear to God.
No, I don't believe you.
We're asking Siri. You're transitioning from being a Mercedes-Benz AMG fanboy to a BMW fanboy now?
I like BMW a lot, actually. I don't know. The CSL is kind of an ugly...
Allocation pulled.
Oh, it's for production.
BMWs. Okay, cool. It's the fastest of the BMWs. That's like saying I'm the fastest of slightly fat Asian men.
Okay, so correction. I was actually wrong. This is the second fastest now. The 2RS, but the MR pack is actually Porsche approved, I believe. You can get it and it covers warranty. I think it's mainly like suspension and aero changes. So, okay. The second fastest production car around the Nürburgring is a GT Black Series.
Okay, so that's what's in the truck. There is a... It was a silver car. It's another three-seater. It's a McLaren F1. Holy crap. Just when you think this display of hypercars can't get any better, the legend, a McLaren F1, shows up in a trailer. The Mouse Motors F1. Central seating in the McLaren F1. Unloading for the Triple F Collection show. Oh my God.
Park wherever you want. However you want.
Park wherever you want. When you have an F1, that's always true. Wow. Wow. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. The red center seat. Twin turbo V12 built by AMG for Pagani. I think that's one of the highest spec'd Pagani Huayra BCs in the world. McLaren Sabre. These are also pretty rare, built only for the US market. Steve's new LaFerrari is full matte black with the exposed carbon fiber roof. The Hypercar Holy Trinity. It's a hybrid, also a hybrid, also a hybrid. So in a certain key way, they're exactly the same as a Prius. A 430 Challenge car, A12 GTS on, I think these are HREs, yep.
Look who showed up!
Matt's here, and this is not planned. We did not plan to wear matching shirts. But I love that you wore my shirt.
I have to represent.
Yes, thank you. Everything is open to the public now, so there are so many people around. Like, holy crap, the hypercar section is packed. It's a great scene to turn off because this is all for a good cause. Makes it hard to get like videos of the cars and things like that, but it's just a really, really cool event and atmosphere so far. There's
food trucks lined up outside here. Minor YouTuber here.
Not a YouTuber.
I literally despise you in so many ways.
You called me a washed up YouTuber.
We're literally in Naples and Mikey takes a picture of me standing in the ocean and he just captures and goes, look, a washed up YouTuber.
I mean, he's not wrong. You were washed up on the shore.
I love my friends, they're great.
We've got the AMG row here with an SL65 V12. And what did you just say, Matt?
Your car is over there, but in yellow.
It's an Audi TT. Matt's very funny. I guess this is fair because I say he has a EcoBoost Mustang with a body kit on it. We both have Shelby 350Rs.
This is a good license plate too, R8.
So Project 7 at the wing, this green metallic paint, the single kind of flying buttress back here. Interior looks pretty similar. Pretty cool helmet. Project 7 embossed on the headrest too. And it's one of those things that you kind of have to know about the Project 7 to really recognize it. Otherwise, it just looks like a F-Type. That's cool. There are some awesome license plates here. Got you, GT2. That's great. The Rohana GT3 we were following behind, and also the Taycan there is plugged in, you know? Any opportunity with an EV, you gotta plug in and get some charge. Full carbon fiber GTR with Carbon Revolution wheels. So these are the same wheels that are on my Shelby 350R, or every Shelby 350R, because Carbon Revolution makes them. But they're exposed weave, which is pretty cool. And then every single panel on this car has been replaced with carbon fibers, which is pretty impressive. Mikey's driving a P1. We have Shmi in his natural habitat filming an F40 and Countach leaving.
Oh yes.
Oh yes indeed.
It has to happen.
Straight
all automotive YouTubers, this guy would win hands down competition.
I doubt that.
We need a demonstration now.
No.
My phone will fall out of my pocket and smash.
That's the lamest excuse. I'll hold your phone for you, Tim.
No, it's fine. It's comfortable here.
I will testify that I've seen it and it's legit. It's beautiful.
One of the most successful automotive YouTubers in the world. Forget that. Forget the cars. Forget all of that. Best handstand in the world. Vouched for by the Burlacker. This is facts.
It's been known to happen in a few thumbnails.
Oh.
Yes. There have been a few.
Now that I think about it, I might have seen that.
Yeah, yes. It's happened a few times. And it makes people very confused. Rightfully so.
If you're Australian, you'd just be trying to be yourself right side up, you know?
Yeah, flip it.
But he's British, so.
Oh my God. Burlacker for scale, from a distance. I'd actually pay to see you try to get in one of these cars, because it'd be...
I drove a Huayra. I would love to get in one of those. I would love someone to pay me to get in one of those.
Yes.
That'd be a win-win-win.
Because for some reason, I don't fit in a Countach. I tried, and I couldn't.
No, so no. Whoey's garage, Tyler, who he bought one?
Yeah.
He texted me, he's like, you ain't ever fit
Never. It's set. GT40. I got to sit in a replica one.
Yeah.
Couldn't fit, it would've cut my head off. And you'd be at like chest level, gone. So.
Absolutely. So the nice thing is, those are very expensive cars.
Yes.
I can't even pretend to want.
Yes, exactly. Talking about all these cars that we can't afford that we can't fit in, so.
I can't fit in the GT350.
Yes, you can. And that's why all of us are GT350 owners.
Respect.
All of us, yes. Yeah. We have fine taste in automobiles. And we got a GT500 owner there, yeah. Right. Where's he hiding? Where's the Brit? There he is.
Are you okay when you're driving the GT500 feeling like you're on the wrong side of the car? Or the right side of the car?
I have quite a few left-hand drive cars.
I think the four GTs that way too.
Yeah, I don't think they built
the
right-hand.
And my SLS is left-hand drive, and my GT3 was left-hand drive, and...
I think Tim might be one of the most skilled automotive YouTube, drivers, skilled drivers.
Yeah.
Left all right. Of the auto, right?
I definitely don't have a
handstands
problem.
Handstands and actually the best driver in the community. Don't tell anyone I said that, but...
As I'm recording for YouTube.
This is what happens when you hang out with Tim. He just comes and says, I have to move the F50. Oh no, poor you, Tim. He has to move the F50. What a calamity. What a calamity.
We have Shmi moving in an F50 and James in the F40.
That lifter button works.
And we have James. Looks good in an F40.
Nice, done.
Wow, the front lift in the F40 goes up quickly.
They want me to
drive this.
Wow. It's also an STO. The interior of the Triple F Collection Sabre. The blue on blue with a Triple F logo and the comfort seat. So apparently it took a lot for MSO to make the comfort seats fit. This is a remarkably beautiful interior. And the blue carbon fiber, look. Look at that. That's beautiful. The fading blue vents here.
Yeah, so that's new too.
And different wheels with the Triple F Collection center cap. That's a badass thing, to have your own crest slash logo on the center caps of your custom McLaren Sabre. The matching brake calipers too. Like, look at this lineup. This is Triple F cars left here. Most of the other cars are gone now. Cars are starting up and heading out.
So this was an utterly amazing, ridiculous event. The turnout was crazy. The cars were awesome. Met a lot of friends, some fans, which was also awesome. And then obviously got to spend time with Mike, which is, I just said awesome like 15 times, and that part isn't really that awesome.
2-1.
What are you 3-2-1-ing? What are you counting down?
3-1-2.
3-1-2 supercars. Oh, I see what you did there. The event is wrapping up. People are leaving now. It's officially 4 o'clock.
Yep.
The cars are amazing. The people here are amazing. Met some friends, some fans. Matt's here, which is, this was just such a cool event. All to benefit a good cause. The cars here, unbelievable. Like, outside of Monterey Car Week, I haven't seen a collection of hypercars and supercars like this, and the quality and the diversity, the differences is just amazing. So this was an amazing event. Thanks to the Triple F Collection for putting out, Mercedes-Benz Easton, all these sponsors for the event. And yeah, this was just such an amazing opportunity. And we've got Tommy from the Hamilton Collection.
You gotta be here next year if you missed it. It was amazing.
Absolutely. So fun. Absolutely. The Hamilton Collection brought out like all of those cars. All the cars. This was awesome. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.